Hello, everybody, and welcome to the beach again. Welcome to another photo vlog. It's been a little while. It's been like a month or so since I've done one of these. But yeah, I want to bring you back out to the beach again, another day at the beach, because, well, beaches are cool. I do enjoy a nice beach. But yeah, the day is clear. The skies are actually really, really clear today. The sun is actually just about to set, which is why I look so beautiful. But the sun is about to set. We have about 0 minutes left of daylight, actually. The sun is pretty much set over the horizon just about now. But yeah, we are here to get some epic photos today. Today, we're doing something really specific, which I will tell you in a second. But, yeah, I'm really excited. And, yeah. Falling apart when you're so far, you're the only thing that I can't lose. I can't lose. You're feeling the cracks, didn't know I had. Melting my heart from the broken glass. Now in every part of me, it's you. So today we are going to be shooting star trails. This is actually something that I've tried doing on stream, or not on stream, sorry, wrong platform, on video once before. I actually came here like 2 months ago or something like that to try recording this exact video here, but it didn't end up really working out too well because I actually forgot to turn on a microphone. and that was a complete utter failure, and as you know, well, maybe if you did watch my other photography vlog video, that the other one also took like 6 or so tries to do. So yeah, this again is actually another like 10th try, which is very funny, and is a topic that I'll get into in a minute. But first, I kind of wanted to explain what a star trail is. So basically, you have your sky here, right? Your sky right there. And at night, if you didn't know, stars come out. Yeah, so you may see stars if you look up at the sky. Especially if you're in a less polluted or light polluted city. If you're not in a city and you're out in like the country, you'll find a lot of stars. For those of you that have never left the city, that kind of sucks to be you. But so you're gonna see a lot of stars in the sky, and when the Earth rotates, the stars, they kind of move in the sky. You never really see stars in the same place whenever you look up, because, well, they move, just like the sun moves, like, across the horizon. And that's what we're trying to capture. We're trying to capture a long line of stars. Well, I don't know if it's gonna go across this way. I think it may head towards the south, because it starts from the south, and I guess that's north. But anyways. So we're going to be doing a bit of that. We're going to try to capture that. This is the first time that I've done astrophotography in a really, really, really long time. So I'm a little bit nervous, actually. It's been a while since I've done anything like this, taking photos at night. So I hope it turns out well. Cross your fingers. And yeah, so I have the camera set up over here already. But while we're waiting for nighttime, or I guess before we wait for nighttime, I guess I wanted to talk a little bit about the fear of failure, and I guess the lack of motivation, which I guess kind of go hand in hand. So for a long time, I guess, with photography, at least, you know, with everything, really, I've always had the fear of failure. I was always scared of, you know, losing. I was scared of doing things and then not accomplishing them. It was horrible. I mean, I'm sure you you know, and hopefully everybody else understands this fear. But for a very long time, it's made me not want to do anything, right? Like the fear of kind of losing and of all that made me not want to do anything, which, you know, ties into the lack of motivation. Those two have played a very, very big part in my life. And I feel like with the these last few photography trips especially, it's kind of dawned on to me recently about why, right? Why are we so afraid of failing? Why are we so afraid of losing, you know, people or whatnot, right? And, you know, in the striving in this road to success. For example, this video, I've been to like six, sorry, there's a mosquito on you. I've been to six different locations in an attempt to take this video. Not necessarily astrophotography, but in general, which I'll maybe show later. Maybe I'll show little clips of it today, but I've been to so many different places, trying to take this video, trying to do lots of photography, and I've always ended up failing every time. You go to a place and you do something and it sucks, you know. You just feel like, oh, like this may be good when you start, and then you finish it, you look at it, and it sucks. And I feel like I can equate a lot of that failure to the comparison, or through my comparison of other people, which I'm sure for any of you that does anything, you see people that are inspiring, that do really, really cool and amazing things, and you want to replicate that, right? You want to do your best to try to envision what that is, or try to encapsulate their product or their art into what you do. And I feel like in the process of that, or in the pursuit of it, I guess, it's made me start to compare myself to other people a lot, compare my photos to theirs. Whereas way back then, I didn't care. When I first started photography using this camera, I didn't care. I just kind of ran around going wherever. I actually ditched college classes to do it, to do photography, which was a really bad idea in hindsight, but I just didn't care. I never looked at anybody doing, you know, any sort of photography. I never looked at anybody doing art. I never, you know, compared myself to anybody because I didn't have anybody to compare to. But the more I got into photography and the more I started looking at other people for inspiration and ways to learn how to improve my, you know, my craft, I guess, for the lack of a better term, it's made me a bit more critical of the art that I am putting out, which in turn makes me start to compare myself to other people, and especially other professionals, which I'm not a professional by any means. So it's a really, really interesting trap to fall into, because there's always the idea of, well, you can't compare yourself to other people, right? You gotta do your own thing and everybody else does their own thing. But the reality of it is that it is a lot harder to do that than a lot of people tell you to. It's easier said than done. I guess the overall message here, because I kind of lost track of my own thoughts, is that, just don't really compare yourself to people. I feel like by doing this video here, I've really helped myself learn to just stop, right? Stop thinking about getting the perfect image. Stop caring about what other people are going to think of it. Stop caring about what you think of it. Stop, like, going into every photo and start pixel peeping every single time you get something slightly wrong when you're looking at your own image in such a high resolution that you can zoom in and see like that one tree out of focus, and you're looking at a professional photographer's image and it's in 1080p, it's a JPEG, and it's on a YouTube video which has like 2,000 forms of compression. And to just do what you enjoy. And while obviously, as I said before, it is far easier said than done, I feel like it is an important thing to try and do and try to integrate into your daily life. Because, well, if you don't do it, if you keep comparing yourself to others, like I've done for so long, it becomes really exhausting. You kind of stop enjoying the things that you do because you're always looking for more. You're always trying to achieve better. When at the end of the day, you're achieving better for what? You know? There's like, unless you're going into a photo contest or something, right? Where the stakes are like $1,000, like $1,000,000. Does it really matter? Does it really matter what other people think of your work? Does it really matter? Like what people think of your art? Obviously, in terms of work, if we're looking at like actual like job stuff, then yeah, maybe your boss does care. But I guess if we're looking at it from art, it doesn't matter. And I feel like that's the important takeaway, at least the takeaway that I've learned from doing this for a fair bit of time, trying to chase perfection when really there's no such thing as it. There's always going to be something that you don't like. And I feel like it's important to like stop and think about that. And to just take it in, and not really care. Just do what you do. And obviously, inspiration is a wonderful, wonderful thing. But I feel like people seldom talk about the trap that it can also come with, falling in too deep, and you start comparing yourself to others, which ends up being really bad. But yeah, so we are now waiting for the sun to fully set. It's 9:50 right now. The sun set like 20 minutes ago. And we're gonna be taking a few photos of some star trails. So I guess while we wait for that, let's just chill out. So, here we are. I have the most jank camera setup ever. It's pretty much my tripod and my phone's flashlight is kind of just hanging off of it. So a little bit jank, but so a few things happened since that last little incursion, I guess. There were a couple people that were kind of like walking around. And you know, they came up and started talking to me, and I, you know, in the midst of that conversation, I actually forgot to do a time lapse that like I was going to. So oopsies. Big boy mistake there. But anyways, it is now, we're looking at 8:51 p.m. The moon has come out, the sun has pretty much set entirely, and the stars are actually out now, which I can't really see because my eyes are, it's getting blinded by this thing here. I should probably get my backpack and sit on it so I don't have to be sitting on the floor all the time. But you know, I could probably do that a bit more. There we go. But yeah, so what I've done today with the camera exposure is I've set it up for 30-second intervals with a 4-second timer after it. So it's 30 interval long shutter speed with 4 seconds in between for the camera to rest a little bit, give it a little bit of a break. But we are pushing that 30-second exposure around 300 times, hopefully enough to be able to capture the stars and to get something nice out of it. I've ended up focusing on the stars, which I hope this ends up working out. I'm pretty sure the 30-second exposure would be enough to, especially because I have my aperture at around 2.8 now, so it's like really, really open. Also, my thing is really wiggling around. Also, I look really weird. Woo! Speaking of which, I guess because we're here right now anyways, A few things have been surprising, actually, with these recent photo trips. Because usually when I've... sorry. When I used to do a lot of photo trips in the past, using the T7i, this camera right here, actually, my photo trips before, I've always went alone. Which I still do now, but like I always kind of went alone, and when I went to a lot of places, I'd usually just be alone. I'd be left alone most of the time. People would kind of just walk past me and all that. Wouldn't really talk to me or anything, nor would I really talk to them. I was pretty socially, I was pretty quiet back then. But with COVID happening, and with everybody kind of coming back from COVID, for a while I noticed in general that people were less sociable. But in doing these camera trips, I've met a surprising amount of people. It's been very interesting. It's kind of odd to see people kind of just walk up to you and just be like, "Hey, like, what are you doing? What's up?" Right? It's odd. It's really interesting, and I guess it's kind of the antithesis of what I kind of expected COVID to do, which was to make people talk less. And yeah. So, you know, hope all is well, I guess. And yeah. hope this photo turns out well. I hope everything else turns out well as well. And yeah, I guess we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. So, we're back again. I kind of got a little bit bored, actually, here. Let me adjust my seat a little bit so I don't topple over. I kind of got a little bored sitting here, because we're at now, we're about 20, 30 minutes in into the shooting process, and we still have a very long way to go. So I've kind of just been walking around circles, really doing nothing. decided to do a little bit of this again. But I guess while we're here waiting for the camera to do its great epic work, I guess I can try talking a little bit about the some of the experiences that I had before. Like in terms of I guess of trying to record this video. I guess it's a fun little thing to do. And so funny, one of the times I went to this particular nature reserve where they kind of they hold nature reserves for like coastal reefs and like little environments that kind of exist in the rock crevices right under the water. And the first time I went there, I forgot the battery for this camera. and so I drove like 2 hours to get down there, and I forgot the battery, and I was really, really pissed off. But I still took some photos. I'll put it up on screen right now, because I never actually got to show those photos on you know, camera or anything, or on video. So that was the first time. And then I went another time. It was a different time that I went again. To I guess this beach. Well, I guess technically that would be before. I'm getting the timelines all screwed up here. But I at some point I went to this beach, I guess this beach. It's a kind of a shore more than a beach, really. But I went to this shore, and I recorded the entire thing, everything. Right? I was even wearing this jacket, this one right here. I was trying to do star trails, which is what I'm doing again right now, just kind of like a redo. Tried doing that, and I finished recording, and I forgot to turn the microphone on. And actually, I had done that twice. The first video I ever recorded, I also forgot to turn the microphone on. So I recorded two whole videos with no microphone. And then the last time I went to a national park. I think it was Kings Canyon, the same one as Apex Legends, that Kings Canyon. And I went there and it was really, really cool. I had hiked up this tiny trail. At least it was tiny on the map, right? It was just like a small circle that you could go to, like this little overlook. What I didn't know was hiking up that trail. I had gone up. It was like a three or so mile trail, 3.5 miles long. But it was up. I think my GPS says something like 4,000 or 5,000 feet. Stuff like that. I don't know if that's actually true, but it was very, very uphill. It was pretty much going straight uphill, like in zigzags the entire time. And it was the first time I had this bag with me here, my new camera bag. And that fucked my ass up. That hurt. That was some of the most pain I've ever felt in my life, physically at least. And so that was not particularly very fun. And when I got to the top, I started recording the video. Now I was gonna post it. But I got to the top and I met this other guy. And we just started talking. And in the middle of talking to him, I felt kind of embarrassed because I didn't want to just start recording while he's just there just staring at me like, you know? And so I just didn't record the rest of it. So that one I drove like 4 hours for and I only got like half a recording. But that was really, really fun. Regardless of whether I got a video or not. The photo I got from that was also pretty shit as well, so I'll post it here now. It wasn't a great photo or anything. I wouldn't really consider it to be like top tier or even mid tier. I think it's a pretty shit photo. There were reasons for that. I was on a kind of a mountain, but facing one side, it was that image, and the other side was like a really cool image, but there's a fat tree blocking the way, so I couldn't really do anything about that tree, you know, short of cutting it down with a chainsaw that I did not have. And I guess, yeah, through all those experiences, I the entire time I had, you know, tried striving for perfection, and it just didn't work out, you know? Tried so hard and got so far, but in the end, I'm getting copyrighted. And I don't know, just the enjoyment of photography. I don't want to make this all preachy and shit like, oh, I'm doing it for the greater good. Because really, I'm not. This is just, honestly, it's really just for me to not be lonely when I do these photo trips. But I guess it's just doing this kind of outweighs everything else. You know, and that's something I never really thought of until, well, like 5 minutes ago. That the idea of just doing photography and just going out and having fun and bringing this second, you know, bringing you guys along and just, I don't know, just dicking around like in some random spot in the bumfuck nowhere. it's really, really fun, you know, going outside, and you know, it gives me an excuse to go outside and see, you know, really, really cool things and to be able to share it with you guys, and hope that inspires all of you to maybe go out and see your own cool things as well, that there isn't, you know, that there's a lot more to the world than just sitting, you know, that than just your room or outside your window or your school or work, you know. And I guess with the world coming to the way that it is, right, this, you know, with the whole environment and stuff, with climate change and all that, kind of becoming a really shitty situation that's currently happening and ramping up even, I feel like maybe this wouldn't be such a bad thing to do, to show you about, you know, just about nature, right? And just maybe showing off how cool it is or something, and hoping that maybe this will inspire you to do things, you know, to protect what nature we have left before we all end up dying in a, you know, hellhole of carbon dioxide. Sorry. There's a bug on me. Yeah, we've got, I'd say maybe like an hour, 2 hours maybe. I don't know what 30 seconds... Wait, what's 30 seconds? So that's 150... 150 minutes. I can't math. 2 hours and 30 minutes, about. So I think I have about 2 hours left of just sitting here and doing nothing. So, yeah. I guess when all this is done, I'll, you know, we'll talk again soon. Or maybe in the car, maybe not. I don't know. So, yeah, to end this video not awkwardly, thank you. Thank you for coming by. I know the end kind of became a little bit of a rant. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Going outside, a little bit of epic gamer nature. I'll show the photo at the end. Or maybe I already showed the photo, I don't really remember. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and like and subscribe if that's something that you want to do. I heard that the call to actions really work, but who knows. But yeah, thank you again for watching, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll I'll post the photo at the end, and I'll catch you all later. Oh god. Dear Christ, oh, I'm gonna break my back doing this.